रेलवे सर्वेंट्स आवर्स ऑफ वर्क एंड पीरियड ऑफ रेस्ट रूल्स 2005 प्रीवियसली नोन एज HOER। रेलवे सर्वेंट्स आवर्स ऑफ एम्प्लॉयमेंट रूल्स 1961 वर फ्रेम्ड अंडर द इंडियन रेलवे एक्ट 1890। In 2005, the revised Railway Servants Hours of Work and Period of Rest rules were notified by the Ministry of Railways by issuing a notification. They shall apply only to those railway servants to whom Chapter 14 of the Act applies. Criteria determining the classification of railway servants. They are continuous, intensive, essentially intermittent, and excluded. Continuous. All employments of railway servants except those exclude from the purview of the hours of employment regulations are assumed to be continuous. Thereafter, on the basis of factual job analysis, the employment may be classified either as intensive or essentially intermittent. Examples: loco running staff, operating running staff, TTEs, gangmen, clerks, etc. Intensive. Two important factors in declaring an employment as intensive are strenuous nature of the work tending to cause mental or physical strain. Continuous application to such work with little or no period of relaxation. This is considered to have been satisfied where period of inaction or relaxation do not aggregate 6 hours or more in a cycle of 24 hours or 1 hour or more in a shift of 8 hours. Example: traffic controllers. Essentially intermittent. The work of an employee is to be regarded as essentially intermittent if his daily duty hours, which should be assumed to be 12 hours per day, include one period of inaction is not less than half an hour, or two such period of not less than half an hour each, and various periods of inaction including the period of inaction specified in clause A aggregating 50% or more, during which is not generally called upon to display either physical activities or sustained attention. Examples: C-class gatekeepers, bungala luskers, caretakers, saloon attendants, reservoir attendants, wayside station traffic staff. Excluded. The following categories of staff shall be treated as excluded: railway employees employed in managerial or confidential capacity, armed guards or other personnel subject to discipline similar to that of any armed police force. Staff of the railway schools imparting technical training or academic education. Such staff may be specified as supervisory, matrons, sisters in charge, matrons not on regular shift duty in railway hospitals, health educators and district extension educators, family planning field workers, lady health visitors, auxiliary nurses cum midwives, projectionists, other categories prescribed. Supervisory staff. Ministry of Labour by written order specify railway employees or classes of railway employees as supervisory on the ground of holding a position of responsibility employed on duties mainly of supervisory character and because of his nature of work comparatively free to adjust his hours of duty or work. Fixation of hours of work. The rostered hours of work of railway servants shall consist of standard hours of duty, additional hours as may be prescribed in the case of certain categories classified as essentially intermittent, and time required to do preparatory and complementary work are both for those who are required to do such work. The standard hours of duty for different classes of employment of railway servants shall be as under: intensive 42 hours a week, continuous 48 hours a week, and essentially intermittent 48 hours a week. Subcategories, their duty hours and their rest hours. Intensive. Weekly standard hours are 42. Weekly rest 30 hours. Statutory hours 45. Basis of commuting 2 weeks 84 hours, calculated for 90 hours, where PNC not involved. Intensive workers can be employed for 7 hours a day for 6 days. Next, intensive. If PNC included for 3 hours, the weekly standard working hours 42, weekly rest hours 30, statutory hours 45. Next, continuous. Category A, 8 hours daily duty hours, 48 hours weekly standard hours, weekly rest 30 hours, statutory hours 52, calculated for 2 weeks 96 hours and total 108 hours. In general, all staff are in the roster where PNC not involved. Continuous. Daily 8 hours duty, weekly standard hours 48, weekly rest hours 30, statutory hours 54, basis for commuting 1 week 48 hours, for 2 weeks 96 hours. This category applies to railwaymen working in electrical, diesel, steam or EMU car sheds, CNW sick lines and electrical staff working on the above places are eligible for the payment of OT at 1.5 times the hourly rate for work done beyond the 58 hours of a week up to the statutory maximum, but the OT at twice the rate that is admissible. Continues, for loco and operating running staff who are working in superfast express trains are covered in this roster. Weekly rest 30 hours, for 2 weeks 90 hours and beyond that 108 hours. Next, for other category of running staff, for loco and operating running staff and other traveling staff are given in link roster not to exceed 104 hours in 2 weeks. Loco and operating running staff are generally called upon to perform 10 hours of duty at a stretch, counting the period from signing on to signing off. They are given 4 periods of 22 consecutive hours or 5 periods of 22 consecutive hours of rest per month, inclusive a full night. Periodical rest. Railway servant whose employment is intensive or continuous shall be granted every week, commencing on a Sunday, rest of not less than 30 consecutive hours. And those whose employment is essentially intermittent shall be granted rest of not less than 24 consecutive hours, including a full night. No railway servant classified as intensive, continuous or essentially intermittent shall be called on duty unless one has had a rest of not less than 12, 10, 8 consecutive hours respectively after completion of the previous tour of duty. Such rest shall be given as far as possible through the employment of rest givers, and the rest givers so provided shall be separate for continuous and essentially intermittent categories. Locomotive or traffic running staff shall be granted each month a rest of at least 5 periods of not less than 22 consecutive hours each, or a rest of at least 4 periods of not less than 30 consecutive hours each, including a full night. The hours of working for this purpose shall be calculated from sign on to sign off. The locomotive and the traffic running staff shall not normally be away from the headquarters for more than 3 or 4 days at a stretch, and the periodic rest for such staff shall be given at headquarters. Rest at headquarters shall always include a night in bed, and as far as possible, once in every 10 days. Staff on duty in running trains other than locomotive and traffic running staff, such as traveling pay clerks, catering staff attached to restaurant car shall be given periodic rest on the scale and in the manner laid down for the locomotive and traffic running staff. Some portion of the periodic rest may, however, be given away from their headquarters, having regard to their length of trips. Compensatory period of rest. No railway servant, in respect of whom an exemption has been made under rule, shall be required to work for more than 14 days without a period of rest, shall be provided with a compensatory rest within this period. Calculation of overtime. Where a railway servant is required to render extra hours of duty beyond the rostered hours, he shall be paid overtime for such extra hours of work. It shall apply to running staff, operating staff, shift workers. Payment of overtime for excess hours of work shall be made as under. For excess hours of work rendered by railway servant between the limits of prescribed rostered hours of work and the hours prescribed during the relevant average period, payment shall be made at 1.5 times the ordinary rate of pay. And for the excess hours of work rendered beyond the limits of prescribed, payment shall be made at 2 times the ordinary rate of pay. The hourly rate of overtime shall be worked out on the basis of rostered hours for the relevant averaging period as under. Hourly rate of pay for staff governed by averaging principle is equal to period of averaging divided by number of rostered hours of week in the averaging period is multiplied by 1/30 of monthly ordinary rate of pay. Next, hourly rate of pay for staff governed by averaging principle, 1/number of daily rostered hours of week multiplied by 1/30 of monthly ordinary rate of pay. Thank you.